Every historical situation contains its own unique utopian perspective, an immanent vision of what is wrong with it, an ideal representation of how, with some changes, the situation could be rendered much better. So when the desire for a radical social change emerges, it is thus logical that it first tries to actualize this immanent utopian vision, which is why it has to end in a catastrophe. And it's here, even if it appears very modest, if you allow me a brief political digression, that the true utopianism today are precisely the modest social democratic attempts. For example, I advise you to read the book. I don't have to advise it to you. Everyone is buying it, and I'm saying this with a certain envy. Fuck it. Why are not my books selling as well as Piketty's? You know, I would sell my mother into slavery to be at that level, you know, of capitalism 21st century. But I think, and you should read the book, you learn so much historically and so on. But it's a utopian book at its purest. Why? On account of its very modesty. Piketty realizes this inherent tendency of capitalism towards inequality and so on and so on. So that the threat to democracy comes from within capitalist dynamics. Okay, we agree here. Also, I hope you noted, if you read the book, the wonderful, tragic, sad lesson of Piketty's book. He sees the only bright point from the 30s till the 60s, no? When this tendency towards inequality was controlled, stronger state, welfare state. But he himself says the condition for this turn towards was what? Holocaust, the two world war and crisis, you know? It says what? And I'm tempted to agree with him. The implicit conclusion is that our only hope is a new world war or whatever. You know why I think he is utopian? Okay, he is in a way right. The 20th century overcoming of capitalism didn't work. But he then generalizes this implicitly. Okay, he accepts it as a good Keynesian or whatever. Capitalism is ultimately the only game in town. All alternatives ended up in fiasco. So we have to keep it. He is almost a kind of a social democratic Peter Mandelson, you know, the Dark Prince of Blair, who said, in economy we are all Thatcherites, you know. All we can do is a delivered distribution, more, a little bit more for healthcare, education, blah, blah. So what I'm saying is that I think he's utopian because he simply says the mode of production has to remain the same. Let's just change the distribution by nothing very original, radically higher taxes. Now, here problems begin. Here the utopia enters. I'm not saying we shouldn't do this. I'm just saying that to do this and nothing else is not possible. That's his utopia. That basically we can have today's capitalism, which basically as a machinery remains the same. Just, when you earn your billions, here are my tax, give me 80%. I don't think this is feasible. I think that, imagine a government doing this. First, Piketty is himself aware it has to be done globally. Because if you do it in one country, then, you know, the story, capital moves elsewhere, blah, blah. But and this is another aspect of his utopianism. My claim here is that, if you imagine a world organization where the measure proposed by Piketty can effectively be enacted, then the problems are already solved. Yes. You know, then already you have a total political reorganization, you have a global power which effectively can control capital, we already won. So I think that in this sense he cheats. The true problem is to create the conditions for his apparently modest measure to be actualized. And this is why, again, I claim I'm not against him. Wonderful. Let's tax them 80%. What I am claiming is that if you were to do this, you would very soon discover that this would lead to further changes and so on and so on. I'm saying that the true utopia, again, and this is what Hegel meant by abstract thinking, that you just imagine one measure, of course, and nothing else changes. Of course, it would be wonderful to have today's capitalism with all its dynamics, just at the level of redistribution, you change it. But this is utopia, I claim. You cannot do it because, again, a change in redistribution would affect that mode of production, capitalist economy itself. I don't know in what way. I'm just saying that sometimes utopia is not anti-pragmatic in the sense of, oh, radical change, and again, no, let's be modest, do this. Sometimes to be modest in a false way is maybe the greatest utopia, you know. To be a realist. It's something like a ridiculous example, I know, and I'm ashamed to mention it because Piketty is not this, you know. Like some Nazi sympathizer who said basically Hitler is right, organic community, blah, blah. Just why doesn't Hitler get rid of this disgusting anti-Semitism, you know? There was a strong trend even among Jews. There was a minority of conservative Jews who basically addressed Hitler in this way. It's a very interesting story. Like, we agree with you, national unity, blah, blah, but why do you hate us? We want to be with you, you know. That's utopian thinking. This is where the old Marxist, so much maligned notion of totality comes in. You know, the moment you observe phenomena in totality, it doesn't go.